Hello, it's Polish Paul VR. Welcome to my channel. And in this video, we're going to talk about Iron Man VR, but actually about why Iron Man VR is a big deal. And for me, it's a huge deal. Let's maybe start from the reveal of the game at the first ever PlayStation State of Play. The first game that was shown was Iron Man VR. When I've been watching this trailer, I was thinking like, wow, that's pretty awesome. But also it had this little sign at the bottom saying not actual gameplay footage. And when they showed the gameplay, you basically just saw those hands slowly raising and shooting. So I was thinking, will it be on rails? Is that what Iron Man VR gonna be? I have no idea. But nevertheless, I got slightly excited. And of course, while watching rest of the first ever State of Play, it was super satisfying for every PlayStation VR owner. I think everyone lost their shit after Sony finished the event and was super excited about the future of PSVR. While of course the other gaming channels and the tabloid gaming channels wasn't so happy because how heavily VR focused the first PlayStation State of Play was. For me, it was just a statement from Sony just to show everyone that they are supporting VR. They're not stupid, Sony. They read internet, they read articles, they watch videos, and they knew how many people said and write about how Sony might be dropping VR, just like they did with Vita. So to me, it was like a big statement from Sony saying, listen, we just want to show everyone that we are supporting PSVR and we're gonna continue supporting it, and that's how it all went. So, bit dramatic, but also super, super cool if you own PSVR headset. What a great show that was, and of course, what a announcement of Iron Man VR that was. So that's when you got our first look at the game, but this game was in the development since September 2018. The developer Camouflage basically had it on their website that they're working on unannounced game. And also in September 2018 they posted a listings for job, and the job listing said, we're looking for 3D artists to work on the next AAA game. So I think the Iron Man VR gonna be massive. It's gonna be a big game, they even saying it's AAA. Of course, when it comes to AAA in VR, it looks a bit different than AAA flat games, because the games might be shorter, but nevertheless the production's quality and the resources what's going into them are probably pretty much the same. But also, Iron Man VR supposed to come out in 2019, so to me it looks like basically what's happened is this game meant to be Sony's big holiday VR game. But of course, sadly, it's got delayed. I've had comments on my channel from people saying, why don't we have big holiday game this year? Year before, we've had Borderlands 2, we've had Skyrim before that, and always there was something there. While in 2019, it seemed like nothing big happened. Even for me, though, Golem was the big game, but I know it wasn't everyone's cup of tea. So what happened is basically Iron Man got delayed, and we know now that it's coming on 28th of February. And Sony, just like Nintendo, they not scared of delaying their games, so they know that it's better to delay the game and have it the game that is super awesome than to have game be rushed out, let's say, and not living to everyone's expectations. So I don't even that doesn't matter to me if Iron Man got delayed. I just wait a bit longer because I know when this game hits the PSVR headset, everyone gonna lose their shit over it. It's something definitely well worth waiting for. The game is developed by Camouflage, a studio that was founded by one of the developers of Metal Gear Solid 4 and Halo 4. Their first game was Republic, and that was founded by Kickstarter. Then they follow it up with other Republic games, but also they've already got pretty good experience in making virtual reality games because they released Republic VR, which was the biggest Gear VR game when it's launched. And it's had very, very good reviews. Since then, it's come out on Oculus Rift and Oculus Go as well. So I've got this game, I never had a chance to play it, but from what I'm hearing, it's super good. So they've got this VR experience, they know their fundamentals, but also, of course, they made the studio a bit bigger for Iron Man game itself. So I think when they was pitching the concept to Sony, Sony must have basically loved it, and probably said, yeah, okay, you're good to go, we're giving you green light, developed as Iron Man VR game. And to me, the choosing of Iron Man as a superhero game for PlayStation VR, It's the best one what they could choose, thanks to the fact that Move controllers sadly do not have thumbsticks, so you have to kind of control everything with your hands. And of course, Iron Man flying around, that's what you're gonna do. I'm gonna come back to controls and how you're gonna be flying later on in the video. But I just wanted to put little bit of info about the studio and what they've been up to in past, because what they did in past was very successful, which is another indication to my point why Iron Man VR is going to be a big deal. Now let's speak a bit about the story of the game. The studio wanted the game to have its own original story, so it will be nothing what you saw anywhere before on movies and or in comic books. Basically what's happening is Tony Stark of course stopped making the weapons and he says, right, time to help people, I've built this Iron Man suit and I am Iron Man now, which of course that's what you're gonna be. It's gonna be so awesome. But anyway, nothing is as nice as it sounds, because suddenly he's being targeted by a hacker called Ghost, and this hacker repurposes all the old Tony Stark weapons, which as we know are super deadly because Tony Stark is a genius. So he developed some dangerous shit in past, and this hacker targeting all the Tony Stark's buildings scattered around the world. So of course it's your job to probably stop this hacker, and possibly you'll be saving the world as well. That's what I'm thinking. I'm glad that the studio went with their own story and decided to make it an original adventure, because everything what you're gonna be seeing in the game, you'll be seeing for the first time. So if the story is good and folds together in places nicely, then it should feel good for the players as well. And from looking at the story trailer that they published, the story seems very nice. Something that I will definitely enjoy, and I'm assuming rest of the players will enjoy as well. Okay, but let's talk a bit about Iron Man's suit, because they designed their own suit specially for this game as well. When they've got their artist to make the suit for Iron Man, the artist basically said he wanted to combine the good old school suit what you know from comic books, but also wanted to make it a bit of a modern era like you've seen it in movies. So he got those two, put them together and come out with this nice looking Iron Man suit. Of course, once you suit up, which I'm assuming that's gonna be seen in the game by you as well, so you're gonna have this nice moment like you've had in Batman Arkham VR, when you like put the mask and saw yourself in mirror and was like, oh yeah, that's pretty cool, I'm Batman. And then you're gonna be of course Iron Man, but also you're gonna get this hood in front of your face and it's gonna follow you where you move. The developers put some effort to this hood as well, so it's got its own movement. When it slightly like follows you, it's not just stuck in your face, so it feels more natural. And of course the hood will be designed as well to stop motion sickness, because that's gonna be your kind of frame of reference, which is nice, because as we know, Sony likes to make sure that their first party games not making anyone sick. But as you can see as well, this suit looks pretty cool, but what's even better about it is you'll be able to upgrade it. Okay, now let's talk a bit about the weapons you will be using. The developers of Iron Man VR been showing their game at various events like Gamescom and stuff like that. By the way, at the Gamescom 2019, Iron Man won the Best VR Game of the Year award, so congratulations. But in this demo you only been able to use those repulsors. Basically what you've been doing, you lifting your wrist up, you know, like Iron Man does, and blasting out your energy beams like that. But also there will be some other weapons in the game, not just this one, that's basically only weapon they've been showing. But also you're gonna be flicking your wrist down and the little rockets will be flying out of your hands. As we know, with Sony's first party games, the controls are always super simple when it comes to VR. By saying simple, I'm not saying you're not able to do much, but they want you to have your actions like most intuitive way as possible. Just have a look how you're shooting and reloading in Blood and Truth and how you play Astrobot. It's all like put together to the minimum amount of buttons, but maximum amount of immersion. Which I'm assuming that's what's gonna happen with Iron Man VR, even though this studio is not Sony's first party studio. I'm sure they've had bit advice here and there from Sony as well, and of course themselves very experienced VR developers, so they're gonna know how to make Iron Man most immersive. And that's bringing us to the flying in the game. So basically what you're doing, while you holding your move, you pulled in your palms down to the floor, and that's how you're gonna be flying around. Now this is apparently feels super intuitive. You just pull in trigger button and then off you go. When you double tap it, you've got this boost mechanic. And from what I'm hearing, when you go fast, it does feel fast as well. Flying, it gives you total freedom of flying, so you can fly around anywhere you want. You can turn corners by moving your moves and stuff like that. So that's awesome, because I always say flying in VR feels great. So this is definitely one of the features I cannot wait for. And it's probably gonna be one of the bigger features of the game as well. And from what I'm hearing, they did some magical stuff and did some magic with the engine, because while you're turning around, the 360 tracking works. And as we know, sometimes, well, most of the time, if not all the time, if you cover your move controller, the camera don't see it and thinks like, let me guess the spot, which is totally different place when you're holding your move. But somehow, due to some kind of trickery they pulled off with the code of the game, all the turning around, you'll be able to move around, and it all should work quite good. So very nice mechanic, and I'm glad they managed to pull it off. So all in all, Iron Man VR seems like a legitimately one of the biggest PSVR releases this year. We've got some cool games coming to PSVR like Walking Dead: Saints and Sinners, and of course Sniper Elite VR, and as well Iron Man, and we don't even know what else gonna be announced. But this year seems like we're gonna get those big VR games we always wanted, and it seems like we're going to get plenty of them. PSVR been around for over 3 years, 4 years this year in October, so I think we finally seen the releases of those games that been years and years in the development. Iron Man being one of them, and of course being superhero in VR is just gonna feel awesome. Even smaller superhero experiences on PSVR, like your Batman Arkham VR and Spider-Man, those two free games, they was pretty cool. I'm not talking about Justice League, that was a shitstorm, but it's always nice to become a superhero in virtual reality. So I definitely gonna look forward to Iron Man, especially that it's going to be this nice big AAA PSVR game we always want, and it's finally coming. Slightly delayed, but I'm sure the wait will be worth it. Okay, so let me know in comment section if you are hyped for Iron Man VR. Are you looking forward to this game? Do you got it pre-order? Are you gonna wait for reviews first? Let me know, drop a comment, and I have a read about it. And of course, if you like what you're seeing, then please press a like, because it does helps the channel a lot. And if you're new to the channel and are not subscribed, then subscribe. It's always better when it's more of us. And that's it, bye.